There are many different ways to track how Earth's climate patterns are changing and how much of that change is caused by us humans.
Today, the American Meteorological Society published a detailed annual report. It looks at climate data from every corner of the world. KCRA 3 meteorologist Heather Waldman joins us now. And Heather, what did that report show?
Yeah, well, this report is the 32nd year that the AMS has published a State of the Climate report, this year focusing on data from 2021. The report is compiled from research conducted by more than 500 scientists from 60 different countries. Here are five of the major findings. First, the global average sea level hit a new record high in 2021. This is the 10th year in a row that oceans have risen to new highs, and last year the average water level was about 3.8 inches higher than the 1993 average. Next, on average, sea surface temperatures in 2021 were actually lower than what they were in 2019 and 2020. A major contributor to that cooling was the La Nina pattern, which causes cyclical cooling of the surface water in the East Pacific Ocean. But even with La Nina conditions, ocean temperatures in 2021 were still about a half degree higher than the 30-year average. It's important to track sea surface temperatures because oceans absorb about 90% of the heating that's produced by greenhouse gas emissions. Speaking of heating, the 2021's global average temperature was one of the six highest on record. That includes both land and sea temperatures. The five hottest years for the planet have all come since the year 2015, and data goes back to the mid-1800s. But one region in particular was notably cooler. The Arctic. Temperatures in the Arctic Circle in 2021 were the lowest they've been since 2013. There were still some impressive heat records, though, including a high temperature of 103 degrees at a sensor in Canada's Northwest Territories. Long-term trends show that the Arctic is still warming 2 to 4 times faster than the rest of the planet. And finally, 2021 saw new record highs for three major greenhouse gases, including carbon dioxide, methane, and nitrous oxide. Global average CO2 levels peaked at over 414 parts per million last year, and that number continues to rise this year. According to scientists at MIT, CO2 levels need to be below 350 parts per million to maintain climate stability. I recently spoke with Dr. Sarah Kapnick, who was appointed as the new chief scientist for NOAA back in July. Kapnick says that these global changes can have a big impact in the United States, and climate research funding from the Inflation Reduction Act can help scientists understand and prepare for those impacts.
The act is really exciting in terms of the funding that will come in for us to handle dealing with the issues of climate change, particularly $2.6 billion for coastal resilience. And for you in California, there's also a tremendous amount of money for modeling advancements and modeling efforts for forecasting and predicting and projecting climate.
Kapnick says that better drought and atmospheric river forecasting are two major goals for NOAA in the near future.